I'm just a normal person with no video editing background who wanted to start making YouTube videos and maybe add semi-fancy effects. I don't really plan on making major motion pictures or commercials, so I was looking for a free, easy-to-learn video editing software. Luckily, I stumbled on Shotcut, a free open-source video editing program that has the potential to replicate similar effects that an Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Resolve can, but with a simpler, leaner interface. It just takes imagination. So let's learn together. Hey guys, welcome back. In this tutorial, I want to show you how to use one Shotcut technique to accomplish multiple effects, like the Parallax / Vertigo effect, also known as the Dolly Zoom, as well as a cool way to animate your photos. In this example, just to make it simple, I'm going to use two images, one background and one foreground. As you can see, I'm using a static image of a forest as my background track. But you can easily use a video to give it a little bit more realism. I'm just going to stretch this out to about 10 seconds so that it gives us a longer video playtime. Now, the second image is a transparent PNG that I'm going to put on the upper track, like that. And then I'm just going to put it into place, stretch that to about 10 seconds. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to try to put the couple in the right position. So I'm going to select the track where the couple is located, then I'm going to click the filters tab and look for rotate and scale. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to move them down a little bit using the Y offset field. So let's move them down a little bit here until we get them to maybe right there. Perfect. So what we want to do now is add additional movement or zooming in effect to this video or image that you're working on. So I'm going to hide the top track just so I only see the effect happening on the lower track. And once again, with the lower track selected, we're going to use the filter called rotate and scale. And in this particular trick, what we want to do is we want to use the keyframes. So I've already selected what the sizing is going to be in the initial keyframe, and now I'm choosing what size I want to make it zoom into in my final keyframe. And so in playing this, you can see what it's doing. So there really isn't a specific rule on how far you want this thing to zoom in. It just depends on how fast you want the video to move. In this instance, I'm barely zooming in. Just to add a little bit more dynamic movement to my zoom, not only do I want to zoom from the center, I also want it, as it's zooming, to kind of slightly move upwards, just to give it a little bit more realism. So once again, I'm going to be using the Y offset, and I'm going to be keyframing that from 0 to about 67. Okay, let's move it a little bit off center, a little bit more, maybe right there, and then let's see how that thing looks like. So that looks pretty cool. Looks pretty realistic. So now let's see what it looks like when we add the foreground image back in, just to get the full effect. So let's check it out. See, already that looks pretty cool. With the foreground image not even have any movement whatsoever. It just looks like they're moving forward. Let's play it again. Yeah, that looks cool. Okay, I think that works. So now let's add the Dolly Zoom effect. What makes this effect so cool is that the foreground and the background move independently of each other. It's best that they are not moving at the same speed, even if they're moving in the same direction. So essentially what I'm going to do is zoom in the background at a specific speed and zoom out the foreground at a slower speed. So since the couple, which is the foreground image, was already set at a specific size, I'm just going to be using the keyframes to set the ending size to change the scale from a bigger version to a slightly smaller version to make it look like it's walking away from us. So that's what I'm doing right now, is I'm just setting the sizing and maybe dropping them a little bit and just seeing what looks natural. Again, you know, your mileage may vary, so you may try different sizes and different positioning just to see what works better. But essentially, you're seeing the kind of effect that I'm trying to accomplish just by allowing the background to zoom in and allowing the foreground to zoom out. So here I am just kind of playing it over and over, testing it just to see if it's accomplishing the effect that I want it to accomplish, which it looks pretty good right now. I think we're pretty much there. So let me just look at it for a couple more iterations, and then I think we're gonna put this one to bed. So I think I'm gonna change the scaling a little bit. Just seeing what it looks like if I move it a little faster. And again, that looks cool. I just wanted to remind you that I'm using static images for this, but there's no reason why you can't use a mask on videos to get the exact same effect. In fact, most of the time when I employ this technique, I use it on videos rather than images. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you like this technique. Next, I want to show you a variation of this technique to accomplish the parallax effect, which is basically a way of making your images and videos more dynamic by changing the speed of how fast the background moves with respect to the foreground. Once again, I'm going to start with the same two images that I had in the previous tutorial. And I'm going to separate them into the foreground track and the background track. So let's start with the background again. I'm going to stretch it out to about 10 seconds again, so we have at least 10 seconds worth of video. Okay, right about there. Should be good enough. And then I'm going to drag the foreground image right in front of it. Again, it's the same couple. And I'm once again going to drag it again to match the background. Close to 10 seconds. That should be good. So in this one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the foreground image, which is the couple. I'm then going to go into filters and then pick rotate and scale. And then I'm going to choose the Y offset setting just to move them into place. So I'm going to move them down a little bit until I find what I think looks most natural in this environment, which is probably right around there. Then I'm going to select the background image and again use the rotate and scale, and I'm actually going to increase the size of it, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this image from left to right. And so I want to give myself a little bit more play so that when I do so, I'm not showing little black areas on the left side or the right side. So now to move the background image from left to right, I'm going to now use the X offset, and I'm just going to try to position the background to the very leftmost place that I can put it. And that's where I'm going to set my initial keyframe. And then once I've selected that, I'm then going to go all the way to the end, and I'm going to change the keyframe and make it move all the way to the right edge of the background. Right there. Right when you see the black area, you know I've kind of gone too far past the edge. And so let's just play it and see what that effect looks like. And so now, look, the background is moving from left to right. That's pretty cool. So what I want to do now is I then want to move my foreground image from right to left. And so if you remember, I moved my background image from left to right, but I'm going to move my foreground image from right to left. But I'm not going to move them as far, so their movement is going to be slightly more subtle than the movement in the background. And so hopefully that differential in movement creates enough to create that illusion of depth. And so let's play it. Let's see how it works here. Maybe make some slight adjustments, but already it looks pretty cool. Let's move the couple a little bit more off center, so you can tell how far they moved based on that keyframe. So again, the foreground image doesn't even look like it's moving at all, but you do get that depth because of how fast the background image is moving. And that, folks, is pretty much what the parallax effect is. Yeah, I like it. Yep, I think we got a winner. There you go. Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. If you want to see more, please click the subscribe button. Throughout my year of playing around with Shotcut, I've discovered some easy tricks and hacks that have definitely sped up my workflow and made my videos look better. If you're curious about how to do specific effects, please comment below so I can create a tutorial video. Let's help each other out. I appreciate your subscription. Until next time.